Turning up the volume. Understanding the intensity of emotions in English. Hello, language learners. Welcome back to our channel. Today, we're going to continue our journey into the world of adjectives, but this time we're focusing on describing feelings and emotions. Specifically, we'll be diving into the intensity of emotions, adjectives. Just like how we can turn up or down the volume on our music, we can adjust the volume or intensity of our emotions when we describe them in English. When we describe how someone is feeling, it's not always just happy or sad. There are degrees of emotion, from a little bit happy to extremely happy, and everything in between. In English, we use specific adjectives to indicate this intensity. Take the word happy, for example. Instead of simply saying, I'm happy, you could say, I'm quite happy, or I'm extremely happy, or even, I'm ecstatic. Each of these statements has a different degree of happiness associated with it. Let's start with the lower end of the intensity scale. When you're feeling a bit of an emotion, but it's not too strong, you could use adjectives like slightly, a bit, fairly. For example, I'm slightly tired, she's a bit annoyed, or he's fairly excited. For emotions that are somewhat stronger, but still not at the maximum level, we have adjectives like pretty, quite, rather. Examples would be, I'm pretty happy, she's quite upset, or they're rather surprised. When the emotions are very strong, we turn up the intensity with words like extremely, really, totally. So you could say, I'm extremely relieved, she's really angry, or we're totally thrilled. Beyond these common adverbs, we also use more intense synonyms for emotions. For instance, instead of just happy, we can say joyful, elated, thrilled. Instead of sad, we might say heartbroken, miserable, despondent. These words add variety and specificity to our descriptions. And that's it for this lesson. Dear language explorers, we hope this discussion on the intensity of emotions has been enlightening and that it will help you express yourself more accurately in English. Remember, it's not just what you feel, but also how much you feel it that matters. Keep practicing, and soon you'll be able to convey your emotions in English with ease and precision. See you in our next video. Happy learning!